Sporting Journal Radio, presented by Onyx.
And when it comes to pulling crankbaits, because there was a couple of times where I was going to switch over to cranks, and I was looking at my rod setup, and I was like, okay, I got to retie that. I'm going to have to do that and do this and that. And I was like, yeah, let's just stick with spinners.
And it was working for you.
It was, yeah. We didn't really need to switch, but I'd bought all these crankbaits. I wanted to try them out, and then I was just going to stick with spinners. But will you run bottom bouncers with your crankbaits? Will you do like a three-way? How will you weigh down your crankbaits, Joe?
Yeah, it's a great question. You know, what I normally do is I have lead core line that I use. So I have lead core reels that are line counter reels, and I have lead core line. And you can pick up a lead core rod and reel combo with a line counter reel for about $100 or less. It's pretty darn reasonable nowadays. And, you know, the kicker there is that the line actually has lead in it, so it'll weight your lures down. And based on how much line you let out, your lures are going to get to the bottom of the lake in that 30, 35 feet of water. Now, lead core is one option, but I don't want people who don't fish this kind of fishing to think that they have to go and buy lead core, and that's going to deter them from fishing up there. I think a person can use a 4-ounce bottom bouncer. A 4-ounce bottom bouncer with a 6-foot piece of mono or fluorocarbon line with a shallow diving crankbait will work just fine. The kicker is lower that down to the bottom of the lake nice and easy so it doesn't get tangled. Some people use snap weights where they'll let a little line out and they'll put a snap weight of 2 or 3 ounces on there to weight their crankbaits down. Some people use deep diving cranks and they don't have to use a real big snap weight on there. So there's a number of ways. Downriggers are another way. And of course, downriggers are charter boats. Many of them have downriggers on, and that's really effective. But again, not everybody's going to have the money or the kind of boat to put a downrigger on. So I certainly want to bring up these other methods. And then of course, Brett, when you get your lures down there, then it's just a matter of letting the walleyes tell you what they want that given day. Every day can be different. So when you put that crankbait down there, you know what? If you and I were fishing together, let's start out with a different crank. Let's start out with different colors. Maybe we'll start out with different shapes. Maybe I'll use a jointed, you use a straight. Maybe I'll use one that's really erratic and use one that's got a tighter wobble. Let's work together and let's figure out what those walleyes want. Of course, the other thing is speed. How fast do you want to troll? I always kid around and talk about trolling like trolling like a drunken sailor. Well, what that really means is when I kid around about it, it's speeding up, it's slowing down, it's making sharp turns to the left, sharp turns to the right, and that makes your lures do all sorts of funky things that will ultimately produce more strikes.
Hear more at sportingjournalradio.com or wherever you get podcasts. Northern Minnesota's Walleye Factory is a year-round world-class fishing destination. The perfect getaway this summer is just a short drive to Lake of the Woods. Fish Big Traverse Bay, the Rainy River, or visit the unique Northwest Angle. To catch big fish, you have to go where the big fish are. Plan your trip to Lake of the Woods at lakeofthewoodsmn.com. That's lakeofthewoodsmn.com.